In this video, we will discuss the reduction of the given PDU into standard form 1. Consider the problem. Solve x square p square plus y square q square equal to z square. Write the given DE x square p square plus y square q square equal to z square. Now we divide by z square on both sides. X square p square by z square plus y square q square by z square equal to 1. We write the power of p, this term as power of p, that means x into p by small z whole square plus y into q by small z whole square equal to 1. If we merge x comma z in p and y comma z in q, then xp by z is changed to capital P and yq by z is changed to capital Q. That means p square plus q square equal to 1, which belongs to standard form 1. For this, to merge small x in small p, we take capital X. For this, we write the factor of x in the quotient of p, equal to x. In this p quotient, the quotient of p is x by z. That means in this quotient, the x factor is x. It's reciprocal. That means the factor, the reciprocal of x is nothing but 1 by x. So we take capital X equal to reciprocal of the factor 1 by x into dx, that means log x. To merge small y in q, we consider the factor of phi in q, that equal to, in the quotient of q, that equal to y. The quotient of q is y by z. Y by z is nothing but y into 1 by z. In the quotient q, it has two factors. One is y, another one is 1 by z. In this, the y factor is y. The factor containing y is nothing but y. So we take this as y. Its reciprocal equal to 1 by small y. So we take capital Y equal to integral 1 by y into dy, that equal to log y. To convert into standard form 1, z must be eliminated. So we merge small z in p and small z in q. While replace small z by capital Z, it is important to note that the association of z with small p is same as the association of z with small q. That means here the quotient of p, the quotient of z in first term, that means association of p is 1 by z. Here in this quotient, the factor of z is 1 by z. That means in the both terms, 1 by z is the factor for both p and q. Then only we replace z. We consider the factor of z in p and q equal to 1 by z. So we consider capital Z equal to, integral of 1 by z into dz, that equal to log z. In case of capital X and capital Y, we consider the reciprocal of the factors as integrands. In case of capital Z, we consider the only factor of z as the integrand. By considering these three considerations, small x comma small z is merged into small p and is converted into capital P. Then xp into small z equal to capital P, and y comma q are merged into small q, then yq by small z equal to capital Q. This equal to, generally small p is nothing but dou z by dou x. In this problem, we replace small x by capital X and we replace small z by capital Z. So in the small p, we replace small x by capital X and small z by capital Z, then we obtain capital P. That means capital P equal to dou capital Z by dou capital X. What is the value of Q? Q is nothing but in general small q equal to dou small z by dou small y. But in case of in this problem, we replace small z by capital Z and small y by capital Y. Therefore, in this notation also, we replace small z by capital Z and small y by capital Y. Then we get capital Q. That is nothing but capital Q equal to dou capital Z by dou capital Y. If you substitute these in equation 1, that means x into small p by z equal to capital P. If in equation 1, then we get capital P square. If we substitute y into small q by z equal to capital Q in equation 1, then we get capital Q square. Capital P square plus capital Q square equal to 1. This is equation 3. This is the partial differential equation which contains P and Q only, does not contain x, y, z, as it belongs to standard form 1. Now we use the standard form working rule to solve this. From the step 2, we consider z equal to capital Z equal to A into capital X plus B into capital Y plus cap C. Equation 4 is the solution of equation 3. Generally, in the working rule 1, we consider small z equal to A into small x plus B into small plus y plus c is the complete solution. But in this problem, we replace small z by capital Z, we replace small x by capital X, we replace small y by capital Y. That's why in the procedure also, we replace small z by capital Z, small x by capital X, small y by capital Y. That means which variables are replaced with new variables in this original working rule, that variables must be replaced. Suppose if we replace x and y, z is not replaced, then we replace only x and y in the original working rule. In the second step, we take capital P equal to A and capital Q equal to B. In equation 3, substitute this in the standard form 1. Then we get A square plus B square equal to 1. From this, B square equal to 1 minus A square, B equal to plus or minus root of 1 minus a square. We substitute b equal to plus or minus root of 1 minus a square in the complete solution z equal to ax plus by plus c. Therefore, z equal to ax plus, in place of b, we write root of 1 minus a square into capital Y plus c. In final solution, we must substitute the values of capital Z, capital X and capital Y. Here, the capital X equal to log X, capital Y equal to log Y, capital Z equal to log Z. In the final value, the solution must be in terms of small x, small y and small z. Hence, we replace capital Z by log Z, log small z equal to A into, we replace capital X by log X. That means A into log X plus or minus root of 1 minus A square into, we replace capital Y by log Y plus C. This is the complete solution for the given PDE. Now we consider the another problem. Solve p square x square plus q square y square equal to 1. The given PDE is this. We write it in powers of p. That means px whole square. We write it in powers of q. That means qy whole square equal to 1. If we replace px by capital P, qy by capital Q, then the given DE changes, PDE changes to capital P square plus Q square equal to 1. For this, we merge the variable small x into capital X and small y into capital Y. For this, we take capital X. Capital X is nothing but the reciprocal of the factor of x in the quotient of p. Here the quotient of p is x and its reciprocal is 1 by x. So we take capital X equal to integral of 1 by x into dx, that equal to log x. By taking this capital X equal to log x, small p into small x is changed to capital P. Here capital P is dou small z by dou capital X. That means we do not change small z. So in the capital P notation, small z is as usual. We change only capital X. So in this notation, in place of small x, we write capital X to get capital P. Now we take capital Y. Here the quotient of Q is Y. Its reciprocal is 1 by Y. As capital Y equal to integral of the reciprocal, that means 1 by Y into dy, that equal to log Y. By taking capital Y equal to log Y, small y is merged into small q and it changes to capital Q. Here capital Q equal to dou small z by dou capital Y. In this problem, we do not change small z. So we write small z is as usual in the notation of capital Q. But we replace capital Y with small y. That means we replace small y with capital Y in the notation of capital small q. Then we get the notation for capital Q. If you substitute Px equal to capital P in equation 1, Qy equal to capital Q in equation 1, then we get P square plus capital P square plus capital Q square equal to 1. In this, which is the partial differential equation, contains P and Q, does not contain X, Y, Z. As we said that it belongs to the standard form 1. According to the working rule, small z equal to A into small x plus B into small y plus C is the solution. But in we replace small x by capital X and small y by capital X, small z is not changed. So in the original working rule, in place of small z, we write small z equal to A into, in place of small x, we write capital X, B into, in place of small y, we write capital Y plus C is the solution of the given four. That means which variables we are changed while the conversion into standard form, same variables must be changed in the original working rule. In the second step, we take capital P equal to A and capital Q equal to B. We substitute capital P equal to A and capital Q equal to B in equation 4. Then we get A square plus B square equal to 1. That means B square equal to 1 minus A square, B equal to plus or minus root of 1 minus A square. Substitute this value of B in the complete solution. Small z equal to A into capital X plus or minus B into, in place of B, we write root of 1 minus A square into capital Y plus C. But the final solution must be in terms of small x, small y, small z. We take capital X equal to log of small x. Finally, we substitute capital X equal to log of small x and capital Y equal to log of small y plus C. This is the complete solution of the given PDE.